إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي هي أقوم ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا كبيرا.
بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. ما بعد. We move on to Surah Ali Imran and our first parable or similitude, which is verse number 101. And in this verse, it is preceded by verse 100. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in verse 100 to set up the parable or to set up the similitude. Allah says, O you who believe, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Have the taqwa of Allah, the way that it is worthy or deserving that you have taqwa of Allah, and do not die except in the state of Islam. Then verse 101 begins the parable or the similitude. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا. And all of you, hold on to the rope of Allah. Obviously, rope is symbolic here. There's no actual rope dangling down. All of you, hold on to the rope of Allah. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا. وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. And don't divide amongst yourselves. وَذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ. And be conscious and remember the blessings of Allah on you. إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً. When you were all enemies. فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ. He brought your hearts together. فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ بِنِعْمَتِهِ إِخْوَانًا. And you became by His blessings brethren. And then another analogy, another similitude. وَكُنْتُمْ عَلَى شَفَى. And you were on the edge of النار, of the fire. فَأَنْقَذَكُمْ مِنْهَا. And Allah Azza wa Jal saved you from that. So this verse actually has two symbolisms in it. The first, Allah Azza wa Jal tells us, all of you, hold on to the rope of Allah. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ. And this is a powerful metaphor, a powerful symbol. Because what does a rope signify to the one who is lost, to the one who is drowning, to the one who is in the ocean and then the helicopter comes and there's a rope there? What does it signify? Many things. First and foremost, that there is an authority or there is somebody there who is able to save you. The rope is coming from on top. And of course, here we have the Hablullah. This is the Habl of Allah. Allah literally calls it my rope. What is the Habl of Allah, by the way? Scholars have differed over this, but they're all the same thing. Some have said the religion of Allah. Some have said it is the Quran. Some have said it is the group of the Muslim Ummah. And they're really all the same thing. But the most precise opinion is that the Hablullah is a reference to the Quran itself. How do we know this? Because in the hadith in Al-Musnad Al-Bazzar and in also in the Musannaf Abdul Razzaq, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that the Quran is the rope of Allah dangling from the heavens to the earth. طَرَفُهُ بِيَدِ اللَّهِ وَطَرَفُهُ بِأَيْدِيكُمْ. One side of the rope is in the hands of Allah. And the other side is in your hands. فَتَمَسَّكُوا بِهِ, the hadith says. So hold on to it. So the Quran and the Sunnah use the metaphor of the Hablullah to be the Quran. And Allah is saying, hold on to the habl of Allah. Hold on to the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And don't divide amongst yourselves. Another symbolism of a rope is that what does a rope do? It lifts you up. It pulls you up. You're climbing up a mountain. If you're drowning in the water, you're going to climb up there. So the rope signifies ascent. So the Quran is going to lift you up. And this is exactly what our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. That Allah azza wa jal will lift people up with the Quran. And He will cause others to go down. We seek Allah's refuge. The metaphor of lifting up. Allah Azza wa Jal yarfa'u bihadha al-kitabi aqwam. So the same notion of the habl raising you up. Another point of the habl, another point of the rope here, the metaphor of the rope here, is that when Allah is saying be gathered together and be united, He is not saying unite on your whims and desires. No, there is a central point. The rope is the central point. O Muslims, don't just unite upon anything. Unite upon the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the rope signifies there's a center, there's an actual place you need to go towards. It's not that groups come together and say, we are united. No. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ. Hold on, all of you, to the rope of Allah and then be united. So these are the metaphors of the rope over here. A very, very beautiful and powerful metaphor. When you hold on to it, you will be saved. And another point, you're drowning in the ocean, you're on the edge of a cliff and a rope comes. If you don't hold on to it, what is the alternative? Destruction. That's also valid here. If you do not hold on to the rope of Allah, the Quran, if you choose to let go, then khalas, that is it. There is no other hope for you. So this is a powerful metaphor here of Allah telling us, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. And don't disunite or divide amongst yourselves, and be conscious of the blessings of Allah when you were all enemies. The Muhajirun and the Ansar would never have been brethren in Jahiliyyah. And even the Ansar themselves, the Aus and the Khazraj, they hated each other. They were at civil war for 50 years. For one entire generation, they were killing one another. They could never imagine peace. So Allah says, remember Allah's blessings on you. You were enemies to one another, and I brought you together. فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ. In another verse, Allah says, لَوْ أَنْفَقَتَ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا مَا أَلَّفْتَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِهِمْ. If you were to spend all the money in the world to try to negotiate a peace treaty and bring them together, you would never have gathered them together. وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ أَلَّفَ بَيْنَهُمْ. Allah brought their hearts together. And then the second metaphor comes, and that is, وَكُنْتُمْ عَلَى شَفَا حُفْرَةٍ. And you were at the edge of a pit of a fire. So imagine you're on a cliff. Shafa means at the edge. Imagine you're on the cliff, a volcano, right? And you are literally standing on a very precarious ledge here. And if you slip, you're going to fall into the fire. Allah is saying, you were on that ledge. You were on that cliff. You were literally going to fall into the fire. What is the fire here? Of course, the fire is symbolic for the actual fire, and it's also for their destruction. So Allah is saying, before you embraced Islam, before you were guided to Islam, you were literally standing at the edge of a volcano. You were looking down, and you were just about to fall in. وَكُنْتُمْ عَلَى شَفَا حُفْرَةٍ مِنَ النَّارِ. حُفْرَة is a large, if you like, hole. مِنَ النَّارِ. So you are on a large hole at the very edge of it, going to fall into the fire. Then what did Allah do? فَأَنْقَذَكُمْ مِنْهَا. And this is exactly what our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said. Hadith is in Sahih Muslim and others, that my example with regards to all of you is like a man who's holding on to the belt of somebody who wants to rush into the fire. And I'm telling you, come back, come back. So the Prophet ﷺ is giving the same metaphor. And by the way, notice here, every one of these phrases in the Quran, we find a similar metaphor in the Sunnah, subhanAllah. It's all matching up together. So the Prophet ﷺ said, my example with the rest of you, if you don't follow me, if you don't listen to me, you're going to rush headlong into the fire. But if you hold on to my Sunnah, I'm letting you come back, I'm telling you to not go into the fire. I'm holding on to your belts, telling you don't go there, come back to me. So Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying, it is Allah's blessing that you followed Islam, you embraced the path, otherwise you would have been destroyed. And these are two very beautiful metaphors in the same verse. Both of them deal with Allah's blessings on us, and most importantly, to remember that the Quran is the rope of Allah, and all of us Muslims need to unite on this Quran. Otherwise, if we do not unite on it, we were going to go astray. And Allah Azza wa Jalla saved us by guiding us to Islam. Otherwise, if we did not embrace this faith, if we were not guided to this faith, literally we're about to fall into that fire, and Allah saved us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all united upon His habl, and may Allah Azza wa Jalla cause this month to forgive our sins and to save us from the fire of hell. Inshallah, we'll continue tomorrow. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.